Bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. Dear friends, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And we're continuing this beautiful journey looking at the sacred month of Allah, Shahr al-Muharram. And we're bringing our focus very much on the 10th of Muharram, the day of Ashura. It has so many fada'is, so many merits that we're dividing it up. Wallahi, we're having to because there's so much to talk about. In this very short reminder, we just want to draw your attention to something very beautiful, which is that the day of Ashura was so significant, even pre-Islamic era, that actually the Kiswah, the cloth of the Kaaba, used to be changed on the day of Ashura. And no doubt, in our present day, it's on the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Arafah. To make it very easy, the pilgrims are on the plains of Arafat, they're certainly not in Makkah, and the authorities now are changing the Kiswah once a year on the 9th of Dhul Hijjah. But historically, it was changed on the 10th of Muharram, Shahrullah al-Muharram, the day of Ashura. And this is alluded to in the following hadith that Aisha radiallahu anha said, "Kanu yusumu Ashura qabla an yufrad Ramadan." That she makes mention that people used to, this is before Islam, people used to fast the day of Ashura. This is before Ramadan had even become fard. "Wakana yawman," and it was the day, "Tustaru fihi al-Ka'aba," and it was the day in which the Kaaba itself, the Baytullah, the house of Allah, used to be covered with its kiswa. "Falamma faradallahu Ramadan," qala Rasulullahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But when Ramadan was made fard, the second year after Hijri was made fard, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man sha'a an yusumahu fal yusumah." Whoever wants to fast, so now it became mustahab, whoever wants to fast the day of Ashura, then fast it. "Waman sha'a an yutrakahu fal yutrak." And whoever wants to leave it, can leave it. But no doubt, if it's from the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, is that he always fasted the day of Ashura, and we want to honor that sunnah, and we want to also fast the day of Ashura. It's certainly mustahab and highly recommended. But we just want to make a final point here, and it's a very beautiful point, about this kiswa. The history of it is so beautiful that we must mention it here. The first one to ever put the kiswa on the Kaaba was King Tub'a, who is mentioned twice in the Noble Quran as a righteous man. His people, no doubt, are condemned in the Quran, but the man himself, King Tub'a himself, was a righteous servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who was on the religion of Allah. And his name is Tub'a As'ad Abu Karib Al-Himyari, and he was from the blessed lands of Yemen. And subhanAllah, you know, he came with an ill intention when he entered into Makkah al-Mukarramah, that he was not happy with not having a full reception from the people of Makkah. And when he was told, "Oh, but these are the custodians of the house of Allah," he said, "Well, I'm going to kill these people and I'm going to destroy the Kaaba." As soon as he uttered this, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished him, because nobody goes into the house of Allah with those sort of ill thoughts and thinks that there wouldn't be a punishment. And so he was, you know, really suffering. It was only till his chief Jewish rabbi that I had with him at the time, he explained to him what his intention was. He made mention to him, "Do tawbah to Allah. Ask Allah for forgiveness." Now in his tawbah to Allah, he said, you know, he fed the people of Makkah, but he is the first one, subhanAllah, who will put a kiswa. This is the al-hibara. This is the al-burd al-yamani al-mukhattat, the pinstripe Yemeni cloth. He will now adorn the Kaaba with that. And he will not only do this himself, he will now order the Jurham, which is a Yemeni tribe now living in Makkah, that he ordered them that every Ashura you are to change the kiswa of the Kaaba. And that is actually the history of the kiswa itself. But what we brought today is not only is that the history of the kiswa from the Yemeni king Tub'a, may Allah be pleased with him, but also that he is the one who ordered the Yemeni tribe residing in Makkah to every single day of every time Ashura came in, this sacred day of Allah came in, to every year to change the kiswa on that date. No doubt, as we mentioned earlier, the kiswa now, alhamdulillah, is now changed on the day of Arafah, but historically it was changed on the day of Ashura. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.